friends, let's discuss current affairs. In today's first question, we focus on the new Indonesian president. This is Prabowo Subianto. Prabowo Subianto came to power after, winning the election, the presidential election. He succeeds Joko Widodo. Joko Widodo. Now, he comes from the same party as Mr. Widodo. But the thing about this is that, he is, I think we'll make it slightly thinner. Joko Widodo is outgoing president and Subianto is the new president. Now, thing about Subianto is that he's a former army general. Okay. Now, Indonesia, my friends, is the world's largest archipelago. An archipelago is a group of islands. It's a group of islands. It comprises more than 16,000 islands. And, you would know that there is this island called Java, which is home to 50% of the country's population. What you also need to know is that the country's population is 26 crore. The 26 crore would make it the fourth most populous country in the world. The top three would be China or India, depending on how you look at it, of course. Yeah, let's make India the world's number, the most populous country. So India, followed by China and the United States in the third place. Now, fourth is Indonesia. And this being a Muslim country, it also makes it the world's most populous Muslim country. Okay. Now, there are these guys here. You would find that Thailand is run by a man called Shreta Tavisin. Shreta Tavisin is the new prime minister of Thailand. Taiwan also has a new, president, Ching Lai Ti. In some places, you'll find the name to be, Lai Ching Ti, which is pretty much okay here. Now, let's look at Philippines. Philippines is also an archipelago. This is in the Pacific Ocean. And ladies and gentlemen, this is run by the President Marcos Bongbong. Marcos Bongbong. His father was also the president. He was a dictator, in fact. Marcos Bongbong. This is Marcos Bongbong Jr. Okay. So, I guess we pretty much covered fourth choices. Here is Malaysia. Malaysia is a neighboring country. These are all countries that are in the neighborhood. And you would find that Malaysia is, run by Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim. Anwar Ibrahim. So, we have all these choices here. It's fun to discuss choices because choices can help us learn a lot more, my friends. Now, there is this fund here, Poverty and Hunger Alleviation Fund. India has contributed a lot to this. This is an IPSA fund. IPSA is, there are three countries in IPSA. India, Brazil and South Africa. So, these three countries, have come together to start a fund that would lend money to countries that are in pretty poor state of affairs, that is very poor countries. There are 31 countries as of today which have gained money from, which have been lent money by the Poverty and Hunger Alleviation Fund. These are desperately poor countries, and most of these countries, most of these 31 countries are in Africa. India over the years has contributed, not now it is $1 million, but over the years, that is since 2019, it has contributed, ladies and gentlemen, $15 million. Okay. So, most of this money goes towards anti-poverty program, something that would like education, self-help group, setting up self-help groups, those kinds of things that would help people come out of poverty. Okay. Now, I'm pretty sure that most of you are familiar with the leaderships of all these countries here, except maybe one choice here, Botswana. Botswana is a country in southern Africa, just above South Africa. You will find these countries, Zambia, Zimbabwe, Angola, then South Africa. These are the countries that surround Botswana. And Botswana is run by the President Mokgweetsi. quit C, must C. Mod quit C, must C. Okay. So, and you know, the currency here is a word called Pula. The word Pula mean, in the local language means rain. So, because it's a country that's, you know, desert, most of it is desert, you know, and arid. Rain is very important in this country. So, the currency itself shows the importance of rain in this country. See, Botswana at one point had one of the highest, you know, GDP growth rates in the world. But it fell on pretty bad times, especially after a large proportion of the population contributed, you know, became infected with HIV. You know, almost 20% of the country's population is in fact infected with HIV. Now, when people get infected with such a virus, such a debilitating disease, it kind of makes them unproductive, which has its own additional cost like healthcare and everything. So, a lot of productivity, you know, depletion led to decrease in GDP, which also brought down the growth rates, which meant that the country is not on the path it was before, you know, this HIV ravage took place. Okay. And Chile. Chile is a country in South America, and its president is Gabriel Boric. Gabriel Boric. Gabriel Boric. What about the fourth, Khelo India University Games? See, University Games started in 2020. That was a year when Punjab University won the overall tournament. Punjab University won the tournament in in 2020 and 2022. Okay, so Punjab University got the title twice, overall trophy. And 2021, it was won by Jain University. My handwriting is a bit shaky today. It usually is shaky, but today is unusually shaky. So, I'll try to be a little more legible now, my friends. Jain University is Bangalore-based university. So, it won the overall title in 2021. Now, what you also need to know about this championship is that while it's mentioned here is that it will be held in Guwahati, you also need to appreciate that it's not just Guwahati. The Khelo India University Games will be held across the northeastern states. Like, for example, the opening ceremony and the closing ceremony plus a lot of events will happen in Assam, where the biggest city is Guwahati. Like, you would have archery event taking place in Tripura, a wrestling event will take place in Arunachal Pradesh. So a lot of these events are spread across the northeastern states. So it would be incorrect to say that Guwahati is hosting a lot of. In fact, all the states are hosting. All the states in Northeast India are hosting this. Okay, I guess that's about it. There's not much that, we need to know more about. You know, the Guwahati airport is called Lokapriya Gopinath Bordoloi. Gopinath Bordoloi is a former chief minister of Assam, and he gave his name to the airport. So, Lokapriya Gopinath Bordoloi International Airport is in Guwahati. Okay, Jayaprakash Narayan Airport is in Patna. Rajiv Gandhi International Airport is in Hyderabad. The Chennai Airport is called Chennai Airport, though the domestic terminal is called Kamaraj. And, Annadurai is the name of the terminal, the international terminal. Panaji is Goa's, there are two major airports in Goa. One is in Dabolim, which is called Dabolim Airport. The other airport is called Manohar International Airport. Manohar International Airport. Also called Manohar Parikar International Airport. Here we go, guys. Indian Navy has come up with a multilateral navy exercise, and it's been happening since a long, long time now. This event is called the multilateral naval exercise. So, see, multi means many. Lat means side. So, when you have bilateral, two sides. Multilateral, more than two sides. So here is basically you have nearly 58 countries, navies from nearly 58 countries have come together to participate in the naval exercise off the coast of Vishakhapatnam. Okay, off the coast of Vishakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh. Simbex is a naval exercise that we have with Singapore. So Singapore-India maritime bilateral exercise. Let me repeat. Singapore-India marine bilateral exercise. This is J for Japan, India maritime exercise. Konkan is with the UK. Konkan is with the UK. This is Singapore. This is with Japan. Milan multilateral. Samudra Shakti with Indonesia. Indonesia. Okay. So, plenty of naval exercises there. And what you also need to know that the chief of the Indian Navy is R. Hari Kumar. R. Hari Kumar. India's rank has dropped, in the 2024 Henley Passport Index. Now, this index measures how powerful the country's passport is, what kind of access do the holders of this passport have to different countries, sometimes visa-free or visa on arrival kind of thing. Like, for example, India's rank is 82. It was 82. Now, the thing here is that, this gives us access. At this, we get access to 62 countries. More or less visa-free or visa on arrival, access to 62 countries. Now, the countries with the most, most powerful passport are six. All six have the same ranking, that is rank one. Okay, rank one would be Spain, France, Germany, Italy. Okay, so Spain, France, Germany, Italy in Europe. Then we have Singapore and Japan. All these countries have, the holders of this passport, have access to 194 countries, my friends. 194. Technically, all the countries either visa-free or visa on arrival. So this is huge, my friends. Now, the country with the least access is ranked 109, and that is Afghanistan. That is Afghanistan. Afghans can access 28 countries. 28 countries. What about Pakistan? 106. 106 Pakistan, and they get access to 34 countries. 34 countries. So there we go. I guess we discussed this comprehensively, and remember the six countries, four in Europe and two in Asia, my friends. Okay. With which bank has IRIDA signed an MOU aimed at enhancing access to credit or financing, renewable energy projects? So renewable energy is the in thing now. The government of India is also promoting renewable energy projects, but they lack access to organized credit, and Punjab National Bank has signed a deal with IRIDA, which is Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency. This is a government agency. So Punjab National Bank is run by a man called executive called Atul Kumar Goyal. Atul Kumar Goyal. Atul Kumar Goyal. ICICI Bank, you all know, is run by Sandeep Bakshi. The CEO is Sandeep Bakshi. State Bank of India, Dinesh Khara. HDFC Bank, Shashidhar Jagdishan is the CEO. Yes Bank CEO is Prashant Kumar. Prashant Kumar. This Punjab National Bank was started in 1895. This, ladies and gentlemen, makes it the oldest Indian-owned bank still in existence. So, among all the banks that are existing and that were, started by Indians, this is the oldest. Punjab National Bank started in 1894-95, but let's make it 95. Okay. So, okay, here we go. Which country's women's team won the team championship gold at the 2024 Badminton Asia Tournament. It is, of course, India. Yeah, India defeated Thailand. India defeated Thailand in the final. And this is women's. Men's tournament. Men's title was won by China. Okay, which defeated, you know, Malaysia. Now, also, you need to know that it was held in a place called Shah Alam, the city of Shah Alam in Malaysia. Shah Alam, Malaysia. Okay. So, just remember, Shah Alam city in the province of Selangor in, or you don't have to remember, Selangor also in Malaysia. So, this is an interesting question. 58th Gnanpeeth Award. Gnanpeeth is India's highest literary award. India's highest literary award is Gnanpeeth Award. This was started in 1965. And it was first presented to, you know, G. Shankara Kurup, Malayalam poet, writer Shankara Kurup. The first Gnanpeeth Award went to Shankara Kurup, 1965. Now, Gulzar and Jagadguru Ramabhadracharya, you know, Swami, and he's also called, you know, Ramanandacharya. You know, Gulzar's actual name is Sampuran Singh Kalra. Sampuran Singh Kalra. Fair. He has won 5 national awards and he's director of films like Machis, I think Andhi also. You know, he directed a film called Kitab, if I'm not wrong. And he is also, you know, an Oscar winner. Of course, you know, famous lyricist that you all know. Jagadguru is, you know, a very interesting person to know about. You know, ladies and gentlemen, Jagadguru is blind. He is blind. Now you may wonder, how come Gnanpeeth Award? He does not even read, he does not even use the braille. But, see, when was born, just 2 months after his birth, he lost his eyesight. He lost his eyesight. This is a quirk of fate. I read the entire story, but it suffices to say that he lost his eyesight. But that didn't deter him. That didn't discourage him. You know, ladies and gentlemen, by the age of 5, he could completely recite Bhagavad Gita. This he could learn by listening to people, by listening to scholars, by listening to, you know, learned men and women. So, you know, today he can speak 22 languages. Can you beat that? 22 languages. 22 languages, and he has written more than 40 books. What? He dictates. He listens, he dictates, and people write. Now, think what you need to know here is that he's written all these books, you know, like this great commentary called Arundhati, an epic called Arundhati, a great commentary on Ramcharitamanas. He is considered to be the India's foremost authority on Tulsidas. Now, how did he become all this? Sheer will, my friends. Indomitable will and great extraordinary faith in what he says, Bhagwan Ram. You know, that's what he says. So there's a lot we can learn from people like him. And I was reading his, before these kinds of classes happen, I prepare and I learn about most of these people. But I found him to be the most, one of the most interesting persons I've ever read about. Yeah. So, yes, the Food Corporation of India's capital has been increased almost double, more than double, to 21,000 crore because, you know, it is now become very important to, you know, cater to in light of the need for food security. Food security is a national issue, my friends. It's what is called an issue of national security. You may wonder why did I use that phrase. Yes, it is true that food security, the lack of food security could lead to disturbance of peace, could lead to civil war kinds of conditions. It has, as it has happened in many parts of the world. In India, luckily, our social welfare system is pretty good. So people are being taken care of through, you know, the PDS, public distribution system, which is more or less a part of what is called, you know, which is of which ecosystem FCI is a part. Food Corporation of India was started in 1965. Okay, it comes under the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. Let me repeat, FCI is a part of the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. Okay, so as of today, it's headed by an IAS officer called Ashok Kumar Meena. Ashok Kumar Meena. So, you know, see, this is fairly important because it is all the food grains that is purchased by the government of India through MSP and everything other means, it is stored in these godowns, FCI godowns. From there, it's sent to public distribution system network through the PDS network to ration shops, what you call fair price shops. Okay. So these are all public sector companies. Barmer Lorry is, you know, lubricants and infrastructure company, lubricants, oil and other infrastructure company. Okay. You know, the Hindustan Aeronautics Limited was started by a man called Walchand Hirachand. Walchand Hirachand. This was an industrialist who started this, you know, in Bangalore. He also started Hindustan Shipyard in Vishakhapatnam. So, Hindustan Shipyard and Hindustan Aeronautics were both started by the same person, Walchand Hirachand. And later, both were taken over by the government of India. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we have signed a new memorandum of understanding with Colombia over the sharing of how to successfully translate our digital, you know, success into, you know, into providing for a better, you know, a better ecosystem in Colombia. This is Colombia, my friends. This is the only country in the world named after Christopher Columbus. It's named after Christopher Columbus. This one, green here, you can see here. Okay. Now, I will just red. This is Colombia. You can see this is Colombia. This is named after, as I said, Christopher Columbus. This is the capital, Bogota, B-O-G-O-T-A. You see, there is a city here called Medellin, and then there is a city called Cali, C-A-L-I, Cali. You know, these two cities, Cali and Medellin, are called the cocaine capitals of the world. Cocaine capitals. Of course, the incidence of drug trade has come down, but still they provide most of the cocaine that goes around the world. CLI Cali and Medellin, M-E-D-E-L-L-I-N, Medellin. In fact, these two cities or this country is the focus of a Netflix series called Narcos. Okay, so let's look at Paraguay. This is Paraguay in green you see here. This is Paraguay and this is Uruguay here. Let me make you familiar with countries here. This in green, you know, is Argentina, pretty large country. In fact, I would say the 8th largest country in the world. We are the 7th largest, right in the 8th place is Argentina. This is Uruguay, Paraguay here. This is Paraguay. Paraguay and Bolivia are landlocked countries. These are the only two landlocked countries in this part of the world. No access to the sea. This is Chile, Peru, Ecuador, named after the equator. Venezuela here, there is Guyana, Suriname, and French Guyana. This is France. This is France, my friends. Actually, France. Okay. And this country in yellow is Brazil. This was ruled by Portugal between 1494 and 1820. Yes, yes. Between 1494 and 1820-21, it was ruled by Brazil, you know, Portugal. That's why the main language spoken in Brazil is, you know, Portuguese. Whereas the rest of the continent was Spain, ruled by Spain, and the main language in the rest of the continent is Spanish. Okay. Now, we'll focus on two countries here, Paraguay. Paraguay, my friends. Okay, I guess we will take yellow here because last time around there were folks like you had mentioned that, you know, red is not greatly visible. So, Paraguay is run by a man called Sebastian Pena. These are all Spanish names. Sebastian Pena is the president. The capital, let's take one or two countries and we could discuss even the capital also, is Asuncion. Asuncion, this is the capital and that's the president. Let's look at Uruguay. In the last class, we had looked at Peru and Venezuela. We'll look at Uruguay this time. The president is Louis Lacalle Pau. And the country's capital is a place called Montevideo. Montevideo. Louis Lacalle Pau, Montevideo. Okay. I guess that should be fine. You know, the 1930 Football World Cup Championship, I didn't think of sharing this, but I think the inaugural World Cup football tournament was won by Uruguay. It's one of the world's leading football countries, my friends. Okay, I guess we could clear this as well. And which payments bank customers have been allowed to, you know, deposit and engage in credit transactions till 15th March 2024? Paytm Payments Bank. See, the action against Paytm Payments Bank was taken because it violated KYC norms. Know your customer. Now, usually when we open some bank account or kind of thing, we would be required to furnish certain details like Aadhaar, PAN and all that. In the case of Paytm customers, millions of those who opened their account, no such access was done. So a lot of people, you know, opened Paytm accounts without, in fact, they were not even bothered, because the bank did not bother them with such questions like, you know, okay, submit your Aadhaar, submit your PAN card and everything. So a lot of activity because no such details had come forth from the customers. You know, people opened these accounts to launder money, to send from one account to another, basically. So this is why the RBI cracked down on Paytm Payments Bank. Okay. Equita Small Finance Bank is run by Vasudevan Narasimhan. Fino, I think it's Rishi Gupta. The CEO is Rishi Gupta. I think it's stuck on this side. Rishi Gupta. And coming to Suryoday. Small Finance Bank. Bhaskar Babu Ramachandran is the CEO of Suryoday Small Finance Banks. I think next class we should bring in what is a small finance bank and what's a payments bank. Maybe we could bring that in. We'll have a separate talk for about 5 to 10 minutes on that. Yeah, we may look at, you know, bringing this question back or some just simple question like, who is the CEO of so-and-so small finance bank? This is Fali Nariman. Fali Nariman, was a famous jurist, a legal expert, especially in a world-renowned authority on international arbitration. And ladies and gentlemen, he was also a Padma Vibhushan awardee. He received the Padma Vibhushan in 2007. Okay. And one more thing is that he was a senior advocate to the Supreme Court since 1971. So that's been, you could say 1971 is a time, my friends, that it's a pretty long time, isn't it? He was also an additional Solicitor General of India. He also was a Rajya Sabha member. I think Rajya Sabha member, he was there between 1999 and 2005. He was a nominated member. Okay. He passed away recently and okay, I guess that's about it. To address labor shortage, one country has signed a deal with India with that we will send our folks to this country called Taiwan. This is tiny country here. It's just about 38,000 kilometers big, my friends. Taiwan is just 38,000 square kilometers, as big as Kerala. You could say as big as Kerala. Okay, but it's in see this stretch. You see, this is small stretch here. This is about 160, or you could say about 180 kilometer wide, and this is a province that is claimed by China as its own. China says Taiwan is a part of its own territory, whereas Taiwan says, no, we are an independent country. Now, this has been happening since 1949, when the communist revolution took place in China. The nationalists, the people who were against the communists, they escaped to this island and established a democratic setup in this country. Okay. Technically, this is never a democracy. For almost 25 years, it was ruled by one person, my friends. But any which way, it's much better than what China is, of course. Yeah. So, you see this, this is South Korea. As you can see here, this is South Korea. This is south of North Korea. I know it's a bad joke, but it is south of North Korea. And South Korea is a democratic country. North Korea is a communist country, single party authoritarian state. And South Korea's, let's look at only capitals, Seoul. Okay. Malaysia has two capitals. One is Kuala Lumpur. The other is Putrajaya. What is it? Putrajaya. That's the other capital, Putrajaya. Vietnam, this is Vietnam. You can see here, this is all Vietnam. It's a very thin stretch. The capital is Hanoi. Too many times we had discussed the names of the presidents and all that. I thought, okay, let's take it easy this time around. Okay. But anyway, I think in the case of most of these countries, we have discussed the presidents, prime ministers a while ago. So, let's get on with the business and we'll go to the next one. This is Ashish Vijay Kar, who has been appointed, the managing director and CEO of SBM India. What is SBM? State Bank of Mauritius. State Bank of Mauritius is the only foreign bank to have been, or rather the first foreign bank to have been given the permission to set up an entirely wholly owned subsidiary, Indian subsidiary. So, this 100% of the capital in SBM India is owned by SBM Mauritius. Okay. So, and this guy is, appointed the, what do you say, the MD CEO. Let's look at, okay, in all each of these places, let's strike India. Okay. So, we can learn. Maybe not SBM. That's the other choices. Bank of America CEO is Brian Moynihan. This is one of the world's biggest banks, my friends. Citibank, Jane Fraser. F-R-A-S-E-R. DBS Bank, Piyush Gupta. It's a Singapore-based bank. Earlier, it was called Development Bank of Singapore. Now, it's simply called DBS. Piyush Gupta. I am Ahmedabad grad. HSBC. Hong Kong and Shanghai Banking Corporation is the full name, but it's not used. And its CEO is Noel Quinn. It's headquartered in London. It's a British bank. DBS, Singapore, Citibank, New York City, Bank of America in a small place called Charlotte. But anyway, you just write this. Okay, I guess we pretty much covered all of these choices. Mauritius is a tiny country in Africa. It's an island country just northeast of Madagascar. You'll find Mauritius. And you need to appreciate one more thing here, that a substantial proportion of Mauritius population is of Indian origin. In fact, the Prime Minister is Pravind Jugnauth. He's of Indian origin. Which institution has launched its new global initiative, digital health, virtually on whatever? Okay, the World Health Organization. World Health Organization. Let's discuss a couple of choices, maybe just the two choices here. World Health Organization was started on 7th April 1948. This is the reason why 7th April is World Health Day. World Health Day. Coming to its head office, it's in Geneva or Geneva. You could pronounce it either way. It's in Switzerland. It's run by a person called Tedros. Tedros Adhanom. Tedros Adhanom of Ethiopia. He's from Ethiopia. Okay. World Health Organization. It's a UN specialized agency, my friends. United Nations specialized agency. UNICEF also is UN specialized agency. This is the United Nations Children's Fund. United Nations Children's Fund. It's headquartered in New York City and it's run by Catherine Russell. Catherine Russell, an American. Catherine Russell. Fair. In the previous class, I think we discussed AIIB, which is the Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, which is headquartered in Beijing. Where is it? Beijing. So, the Maharashtra Assembly has unanimously passed a 10% reservation for Marathas in, government jobs and education. See, usually reservation goes like this. Let's look at reservations. Central government and 27% is NC-OBC. NC-OBC. Non-creamy, other backward classes. Then 15%. Is scheduled caste, 7.5% is scheduled tribe, okay? So, then there is EWS, 10% EWS, So, when we say 10%, please know that this 10% is within the general category. Okay. So, now the Maharashtra government has come up. See, there is a ceiling. Supreme Court mandated ceiling of 49.5%. If you add up this, the first three, it comes to 49.5%. So, it says that reservation cannot go beyond this, but constitutional amendments have been brought in. And to, allow such, exceptional cases. Okay. So, let's go past this. And which group has launched a naval mission named Aspides? To protect ships and everything in the Red Sea from the attacks by Houthi rebels. See, let me use red here. Okay. So, guys, this is the Red Sea. This is the Red Sea. You can see this is the Red Sea. I'll write in red then. This is an extension of the Indian Ocean. This is what is called an inlet sea. What is it? Inlet sea. It is about 2250 kilometers long. 2250 kilometers. And, you see this is here, narrow channel here. This is called a strait. A narrow channel of water that separates two land bodies is called a strait. A narrow channel of water that separates two land bodies is called a strait. Between India and Sri Lanka, we have the Park Strait. We have the Park Straits. So, you have here, the name of the strait, if you want to write, is Bab Al Mandeb. Babal Mandeb. That's the name of the strait. But in India and Sri Lanka, we have Park Strait, PLK. Here, there's Babal Mandeb. Now, this sea route brings you to Suez Canal. This is Suez Canal. It's about 180 kilometers long. and you know, it kind of connects with the Mediterranean Sea, which means ships don't have to travel around Africa to come here. So they save nearly 10,000 kilometers worth of fuel, my friends, which is a lot of fuel, isn't it? And expedites delivery of cargo and everything, movement of people and all. So there are in Yemen, this is Yemen, this country is Yemen, okay? You can see here, this is Yemen. This country is home to a substantial proportion of this country here is controlled by the Houthi rebels. Houthi rebels are Shia Muslims, okay? They are supported by Iran. That is the reason I mentioned Shia, because Iran is Shia, okay? All these equipment and everything comes from like this. Fair. So you need to be careful here. Saudi Arabia has always been anti-Shia, and they have bombarded this part of the world for nearly 4 years, but not much success. Yeah. In fact, these guys have been attacking ships here in all these places. So, and the international community has not been able to do much, my friends. So, I guess that's about it. Nothing more than this. You don't need to know about the leadership of, what is this, Yemen and all that, because only on paper there is a leadership. Gulf Cooperation Council. GCC's Gulf Cooperation Council. Okay, says it would have 6 countries. Kuwait, 1. Bahrain, 2. This is the tiny country of Bahrain. You see this dot here where I put this? This is Qatar, 3. Okay, 4. United Arab Emirates, 5. Saudi Arabia, okay, 6. Oman. So there are 6 countries here. There are 6 countries. That's about it. That's the Gulf Cooperation Council. Fair? Now, in fact, Oman is also, you know, it's thinking of going out. Iraq could come in. But any which way, it does not matter. You know, the SARC is the South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. Let me repeat, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. This was started in 1985. It's headquartered in Kathmandu. Okay. It's run by a man called, the Secretary General is Ghulam Sarwar. Ghulam Sarwar of Bangladesh. So, 1985 is when it was started. Kathmandu is where the Secretary General sits. Ghulam Sarwar is, this is a spelling. Ghulam Sarwar of Bangladesh is the Secretary General. It has 8 members. Now, how do you remember? The best way to remember is to draw a map. And you can actually draw a map like, you can say, you know, it's easy that way. You have Afghanistan, 1. Pakistan, 2. India, 3. Nepal, 4. 5. Bhutan, 6. Bangladesh, 7. Sri Lanka, 8. Maldives. See, it's easy. Afghanistan, Pakistan, India. Reference to India. Afghanistan, Pakistan, India, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Maldives. All 8 countries have come. So it's easier, you know, to when you draw a map and actually put your, you know, all these countries in perspective. Okay. So I guess that's about it. The European Union has 27, members. It's headquartered in Brussels, Brussels, which, as you know, is the capital of Belgium. Okay. And, you know, you also need to appreciate the fact that this is a world body that, you know, considered to be a pretty powerful body, but it's not doing great, actually. Okay, which Indian state has collaborated with the World Bank to launch an innovative finance facility for climate resilience and everything? It's Goa. Goa is a tiny country state, and India's smallest state by area. Smallest state by area, my friends. I'm using all kinds of pens. I wanted to use yellow, but any which way. Smallest by area. Okay. And, you know, Gomantak, Gorastra, Goparastra are all old names of Goa. Old names of Goa. It was ruled by Portugal till 1961. that year, we launched Operation Vijay to liberate Goa and integrate it with India. Okay. So, I guess that's about it. And is there anything that we could discuss here? Not much, actually. Which fintech company has partnered with Jammu and Kashmir Bank, Indian Bank, and more 5 banks actually to offer virtual cardless, hardless, you know, hardwareless cash withdrawal service? Paymart India. These kinds of innovations have been coming. See, India is a global leader in all these things. Please know that. Nowhere is a digital ecosystem as widespread, as popular, and as successful as it is in India, friends. Okay. So, if you look at, for example, JNK, it's run by Baldev Prakash. Its CEO is Baldev Prakash. You write in full, Baldev Prakash. Indian Bank CEO is Shantilal Jain. Okay. What about the choices? You would know anyway. I'll just bring in one particular thing. You see this PhonePe here. PhonePe was started by 3 persons, my friends. It started by 3 persons. Its parent company is today Walmart. Walmart, the American retail multinational, owns PhonePe. Okay. It was started by 3 persons. Burgeon Engineer. Rahul Chari and Samir Nigam started PhonePe. Of course, now Walmart is the owner of this company. Okay, I guess from here we could go to something else. You know, Walmart is so big that it actually employs. It is the world's biggest private sector employer. It employs nearly 23 lakh people, my friends. Its turnover is about $620 billion. That's a lot of money, my friends. Okay, which lender has approved a $23 million loan to enhance quality financial technology, education, research, and Gift City? What is Gift City? Gift City is Gujarat International Finance Tech City. Remember this. This is the spelling. Finance Tech City. Gujarat International Finance Tech City is India's first greenfield smart city. There are two kinds of terms that you could come across, like greenfield, brownfield. Greenfield is something entirely new. So if you have a greenfield airport, it's a new airport built from scratch. A brownfield airport is a modernization of an existing airport. Okay, modernization of an existing airport or any facility is called brownfield. Greenfield is green is new, so it's a new facility. Okay, so the Asian Development Bank is headquartered in a place called Manila. Where is it? Manila, the capital of Philippines. Manila. And its president is a guy called Masat Sugu Asakawa of Japan. Okay. AIB, a while ago we discussed this. It's headquartered in Beijing and it's run by Jin Likan of China. That's the president's name. Jin Likan. Okay. So, Gujarat's, the Gift City is home to 23 world-class banks. Bank of America, JP Morgan, all have this, their offices in this place. Which artificial intelligence company has unveiled the world's first, no-code computer vision platform called Pratham? It's Asset AI. So, I'm not going to discuss much about this, but, you look at this company called Happiest Minds. It's an Indian technology company. It's run by a man called Sashi Kumar. That's the CEO's name, Sashi Kumar. It's quite a famous company, Sashi Kumar. If I'm not wrong, it is Sashi Kumar. Okay. So, in case I'm incorrect, I'll correct myself in the next class. Okay. Okay, here let's clear this. There was this new tournament that was started in Germany in a place called Wissenhaus, a small resort town called outside the city of Hamburg, which is quite famous. A resort called Wissenhaus, it was played there. And remember this, GOAT is greatest of all time. What is it? Greatest of all time challenge. The 2024 Freestyle Chess GOAT Challenge. So if you say Messi is GOAT, it means greatest of all time. Virat Kohli is GOAT, Sachin is GOAT, like that. So it was won by Magnus Carlsen. And, you know, these guys are, you know, of course, India's, this is world number two. You know, the rankings keep changing because between Nakamura and Caruana and a guy called Ding Ling. Okay, Diren Ling otherwise. Diren Ling. Between these three guys, number two rankings keep changing. This is this Carlsen chap from Norway. He's the undisputed world champion, my friends. He's also the highest ranked chess player in the history of the game. Okay. Pragnananda Ramesh Babu, Vidit Gujarati, Vishwanatha Anand are top three ranked Indians. Chess players. Shanti Prayas is military exercise that took that involved Nepal. Of course, it took place in Nepal. So, you know, Nepal, as you know, is a was a former Hindu kingdom, and you should know that, my friends, its prime minister is a guy called Pushpa Kamal Dahal. Okay, it's not writing here. Pushpa Kamal Dahal, D-A-H-A-L, Pushpa Kamal Dahal, okay. So, you have Pushpa Kamal Dahal as the Prime Minister of Nepal, and you also need to appreciate the fact that, you know, it is the only country in the world whose flag is a double triangle. It's like this. Its flag is a double triangle. It's the only such flag in the world, okay. Bhutan's Prime Minister is sharing Tobge. Sharing Tobge. Fair? So, after this class, check out the flag of Nepal and you will know what I'm talking about. Because most of the flags are either squares or rectangle. Most actually are rectangle. KVS Manian has recently made the MD, joint MD of Kotak Mahindra Bank, because the other MD is Ashok Vaswani. Ashok Vaswani is the MD of, what is his bank? Kotak Mahindra Bank. And Manian has made the joint MD. Joint MD. IndusInd Bank, Sumant Katpalia. Sumant Katpalia is the MD. Oh, there is some problem with this part of the screen. Never mind. It is LIA, Common Katpalia. Okay. Bandhan Bank run by Chandrasekhar Ghosh. Chandrasekhar Ghosh. So, from here, let's go to the next one. And you will find that this question is about, you know, an app store, which is made by PhonePe. Indus App Store has been launched as a rival to Google Play Store, and it's done by PhonePe. I think we mentioned a little about PhonePe a while ago. MobiQuick has been started by two persons. One is Upasana Singh, Upasana Taku, and this is the second is Bipin Preet Singh, Bipin Preet Singh. Preet Singh. And just two choices should be fine, my friends. Okay. Have a lot of fun and please make sure that you learn. Stay curious, my friends. Thank you for being here. Thank you.